remain your host, Elijah Otanimola. Thank you for joining me on this episode, and I'm so excited to be with you once again. Please, if you are yet to subscribe on this channel, please kindly do so now and look at the bell icon beside it. Click on it. That way you have turned on the post notifications to receive recent updates on this channel. Today I want to talk on the subject, do this while waiting for your soulmate. I believe there's one major thing you need to focus on while waiting for your soulmate, and that is yourself. Focus on yourself. Focus on developing yourself. And I believe there are seven major areas where you need to focus on personal development. The first thing is spiritual sensitivity. Develop your spiritual sensitivity. Develop your sense of hearing from God and understand how God speaks to you. Because when it comes to the matter of your soulmate, God will likely not speak to you in a different way than He has been speaking to you before. And when you have mastered and understood how He speaks to you, then you'll be able to recognize His voice when He's talking to you about the person that He has ordained for you as your partner. The second aspect you need to focus on is your character development. Develop your character. Develop your character. Stop saying, if he doesn't accept me the way I am, then he doesn't deserve me. If she doesn't accept me the way I am, then she doesn't deserve me. My dear, nobody wants a character. Nobody wants someone who is character deficient. Nobody deserves such. So develop your character. Develop your character. It is very important. It's not just for your partner, but also for yourself. Develop your character, because that is what your children will live to emulate. And that is very important. The fourth aspect you need to focus on is your intellectual capacity. Develop your intellectual capacity. Learn how to hold intelligent conversations. It is very important, because marriage is not just about you sleeping under the same roof or sleeping together, having sex together. Marriage goes beyond that. It's a lifelong thing, and you must understand that the major part of marriage is all about communication, and you need to be able to match up with the intelligence of your partner if you want to really work together as husband and wife, if you want to enjoy the reality of heaven and marriage. It is very important for you to develop your intellectual capacity. Then the fourth aspect is your financial capacity. Develop your financial capacity and your financial intelligence. Learn how to create values to attract financial rewards. It is very important. Stop waiting for that man to sponsor you. You shouldn't be a liability to your spouse. You should be an asset. It is very important. The fifth aspect you need to focus on is your social and relational skills. Develop your social and relational skills. Learn how to make new friends. Learn how to relate to people. Learn how to interact to people. Learn how to be friendly with people. It is very important. Develop your social skills. Learn how to look good. Learn how to represent well in the public. It is very important. The sixth aspect you need to focus on is your emotional maturity and intelligence. This is very important. Master your emotions. Understand your emotions. Understand what turns you on sexually. It is very important. In this way, you will not be exploited by people around you. Master your emotions. Master your temper. It is very important. Understand yourself. Understand your limits. Understand your limitations when it comes to the opposite sex. It is very important. Master this aspect. The seventh aspect I believe you need to focus on is get clarity concerning your vision and your purpose. I said it to single young men. I tell them, if you have not discovered God's purpose for your life, then you have no business finding an helper, finding a soulmate, because the Bible says, I will find for him a helper suitable for him. It is very important, because you don't need an helper if you don't understand what you need to do, what you have been asked to do. It is very important for you to get clarity concerning your vision and your purpose. It will help you to be able to recognize correctly the person that God has ordained for you. It is important to help you to be able to identify who will be complementary to that vision and purpose that God has given unto you to execute. It is very important. Someone said, stop waiting, start living. It is very important. While waiting, don't go about scouting for who will be your soulmate. Don't go about scouting, getting anxious, getting worried when the person will show up. My dear, focus on yourself during that time. When you focus on yourself, you relieve yourself from too much anxiety of being in a relationship. I'm not saying you shouldn't think about it. I'm not saying that you should not be open to relationships. But I'm saying that focus on yourself. Focus on yourself. A lot of singles, they are facing so much pressure in this aspect because they are focusing too much on getting the right person. Whereas when you focus on yourself, it makes it easier for you to attract the right person. You know, Adam was busy with personal development when the woman showed up. He was busy enlarging, exploring his intellectual capacity when the woman showed up. He understood himself. He had discovered himself before the woman showed up. So, therefore, when the woman showed up, he was able to recognize and say, "This is the bone of my bone and the flesh of my flesh." That is saying that he has understood himself. Then he was able to understand, he was able to recognize his woman. Listen to this. You won't be able to recognize your like mind if you don't understand what your mind is like. Let me say that again. You cannot recognize a like mind if you have not understood what your mind is like, what your mindset is like, what your ideologies are like, what your principles are. You won't be able to recognize a like mind. It is very important. Isaac at the same time was busy with personal development when Rebecca showed up. Something just clicked inside him. He was convinced when he saw Rebecca that this is indeed this person that God has ordained for me. When Rebecca was also busy with personal development when she was found. She was not going about trying to seduce men to get their attention. No, she was busy with personal development. She was busy with productivity. It is very important. And when she saw Isaac, something stirred up in her to ask, to confirm that is this the person we are going to meet. She was not busy asking the servant that came to find her. She was not busy asking him about every male figure they met on the way. When she sighted Isaac, I believe she had a conviction. All she needed was a confirmation. A lot of you are going to prophets, you are going to pastors, you are going to one place or the other, compiling names, trying to figure out who the person is. That is because you have not developed yourself. If you have developed yourself, you don't need to submit many names. You will only be convinced about one person, and you seek confirmation. That's all you need. It is very important. Why must I develop myself? What would this do for me? Four things I believe this will do for you in getting connected to your soulmate. Four things I believe personal development will do for you. The first thing is that it will help you to minimize and eradicate confusion. A lot of you are confused as to who to marry, who the right person is, because you have not developed yourself. When you have developed yourself in those seven aspects, you will be able to minimize and eradicate confusion. You'll be able to streamline your options. You have gotten clarity about your vision and your purpose. You'll be able to streamline the people that are around you. You'll be able to know whether who the people that are complementary to what you have been ordained to do. You have developed yourself. It's spiritual sensitivity. You'll be able to identify what God is saying per time and per season. That is very important. It helps you to minimize and eradicate confusion. The second thing that this will do for you is that it will help you to recognize your soulmate when he or she shows up. Adam had developed himself correctly. When the woman showed up, he was able to recognize her. Isaac did the same thing, personal development. When Rebecca showed up, he was able to recognize him. Rebecca was able to recognize Isaac because she had developed herself. Develop yourself. The woman was not in confusion when she met Adam, because she was also convinced. She has been made. The third thing this will do for you is that it will help you to be recognized by your soulmate when you meet up. By the time you come in contact with your soulmate, you will be recognized by him or her. A lot of you, your soulmate is around you, but he or she cannot recognize you because you have not developed yourself to the image he has been he has been related with. You look unfit. You look unfit to that structure. You look unfit to his vision. You look unfit to his purpose. You know why? It's not because you don't have it inside of you. It's not because you have not been given the capacity to fit into it, but because you have not developed that capacity. So he's not seeing you. He's not seeing you because he's seeing the raw you. He's not seeing the refined you. He's not seeing the made aspect of you. The woman was made, Adam was made, Isaac was matured, he was made, Rebecca was busy with personal development, she has been developed. That is very important. The fourth and the last thing it will do for you, I believe it should do for you, is that it will help you to see marriage as a life enhancement, not as a life stop. A lot of you, because you are busy waiting and you are idle while waiting, you are not living, you are not developing yourself. You have seen marriage as, the end goal. That's the goal I need to accomplish. The moment I find my soulmate, then I'm fulfilled. That is why a lot of you are in marriage, then you are useless in marriage. There's nothing you can offer. There's nothing you can deliver. And that is because you have not developed yourself. You have seen marriage as a life stop, as the end of your life, not as a life enhancement. God didn't design marriage to be the end of your life. God designed marriage to be the beginning of a higher phase of your life. That's why the Bible says, two shall put 10,000 to flight. Two are better than one. You know what? Marriage is designed to make purpose fulfillment easier, faster, and smoother to accomplish. It is very important for you to understand this. These are the benefits personal development will do for you. One thing you need to focus on while waiting for your soulmate: yourself. Develop yourself. I believe you have been able to get something on this episode, and I believe I'll be coming up with something more interesting on the next episode. And please watch out for my Facebook Live show. It is coming out very, very soon. And please don't forget to subscribe and turn on post notifications. Till I come your way next time, stay blessed, stay safe, and bye for now.